All right, we're back in action for the third video in 2 days. And yes, I do have a life outside of this channel and VIP Kid, or who am I kidding? No, I don't. I don't have much of a life. Other than VIP Kid and running and family stuff, that is about it for me. I felt compelled to do this video today because VIP Kid came out with a very interesting email today with their update, as well as the video. So I want to get into that. It is a very worthwhile video to watch. A lot can be said from that video, and it touches on things that I've really been hitting home the last few weeks. Also, I'll do my usual of sharing a tip on weight loss, which I'm just starting here now. And then we'll go into finally, just appropriate stuff in the classroom. So I've been put into 3 delicate situations now in the last couple months. I just posted something on the Hutong about it, asking VIP Kid to maybe do something about it, and I'm going to share what I've seen. And again, I know VIP Kid is in a delicate situation here too, so I'm not expecting the world from them, but I'll describe what I've seen and just what I've posted on the Hutong there today. So let's get right into it here today. Thank you for coming back to the channel. I do appreciate it, and let's get right into it. So the first thing, weight loss tip, or just weight control tip in general. So I mentioned one yesterday, and I'll go into another one. This one's a little more fun, or a little bit more appetizing, I should say, than eating more raw vegetables, which was yesterday. The one today is we want to snack. We definitely want to snack. And yes, vegetables are a great way to snack, or fruit, excellent way to snack to reduce your calories and be full. Another way, sometimes we just need that sugar fix. We all need that sometimes, and our body wants that sometimes. And we need to give in sometimes to that. And what I've found the best way to do that is with some kind of a candy that you can suck on for a while. And maybe that's a few candies. What I use are Werther's. So those that you can suck on for a while, maybe they last 5 minutes each. I think they're around 15 calories each, so they're not very many. You could have, you know, 4 or 5 of them, and that's enough to just maybe hold you over to the next meal. So this one's a little more fun, is when you need that sugar fix, have something like a candy that will trick your mind into thinking that it's getting something substantial, and you get to suck on it for a while. So I love that one as a tip to at least get you to the next meal. Okay, let's get right into the video. So take a look at the teacher update out today. This one was very pertinent for what's going on right now, and I'm just going to summarize it for you, at least some of the key things that I've taken from it. So they go right into the crux of matters, and kudos for VIP Kid for not just ignoring the elephant in the room, but rather they go and they address the issue, which is low bookings that all of us are feeling right now. I mean, the ones that are seeing normal bookings would be the minority. I would say 5% or less. And those people probably don't open many slots. But for those of us that open up lots of slots, or for the rest of us, we're seeing a lot, a big impact here on our bookings. So they addressed the elephant in the room, and they gave some good stats here for it. And one thing that is an eye popper to me is the amount of slots that are opened up this year, 2020 in April, compared to last year, 2020, has almost doubled. The slots available has almost doubled. And they address in the video that the teachers have not doubled in that amount of time, but we know from common sense, with all of the coronavirus and whatnot and people staying home and not going to work, that of course the teachers that are there are opening up more slots. So the amount of slots year over year in April has almost doubled, and unfortunately May will probably be doubled from last May, or around the same, and that trend is going to stay there at least for the foreseeable future. I really do think July is when we turn the corner. Now, a couple comments were mentioned that things probably won't get back to relative normality until September. Yes, I think September is also a big month, but I think July is when there are going to be a lot fewer slots available. Yes, the bookings, they do address that the bookings will likely decrease a bit in the summer, but I think the supply of teachers is going to Also, the amount of slots are going to decrease dramatically. With summer vacations, people have been cooped up in their houses. They're going to want to get out of here and do something different. Take a staycation or something, but teach less. So I think the amount of supply will come down significantly in July. So that's really the month that I'm looking for. And right now, that's only a few frenzies away. We're already booking into very close into June here now. So we're getting there. So we just need to hang in there. Unfortunately, May has been rough. June's going to be rough, but I think July will turn around for us. So do take a look at that video. Very, very informative. One thing they mentioned on there, which was interesting wording, is they talked about that the amount of projected teachers is exactly what they thought it would be. They didn't say how many. They just said that's how many they were projecting. Well, they could have been projecting a lofty amount because they saw the writing on the wall as well that they're going to be flooded with applications. I would love to know how many teachers they've taken in the month of, let's say, April, for example, or March. That would be very interesting to know what the teacher count is right now. But they didn't mention that, probably for obvious reasons in the video. So anyways, that's a key thing there to keep in mind. Let's go into now a sensitive issue that I've run into multiple times, unfortunately, in the last little bit. And I've addressed this on the Hutong to see if VIP Kid can do something. Before I go into that, please do like my video if you do like the video or find something useful. I do videos every few days. I do not accept referrals, so please like the video. That will help it get more views, and also subscribe to the channel. That's the only way. I'm on a drive to 1,000. I'm at 147. Thank you for my subscribers. I love subscribers. It's great. Makes my day. Thank you for that. Please bang on that subscribe button. So, a sensitive issue I've run into, and I know it's not just me as one male teacher, it's also other male teachers, it's also female teachers, and female teachers may be getting it even worse, but I've just been running into nudity in the classroom. So again, a lot of it's unintentional, I know, and I feel compelled for VIP Kid to try and do something, just something that is just a gentle reminder on what is appropriate attire, appropriate in the classroom. So situations that I've run into, and I'm sure everyone's run into these situations, it's not just me, it's others. I've read about other situations on the Hutong, but just some students just not appropriately dressed for class. I'll just leave it at that. Students, and I'm talking about girls here, I'm not talking about boys. Boys I haven't had an issue with, you know, maybe they take their shirt off, but obviously I don't care about that. I do have a 5-year-old girl as well. I do have a 2-year-old boy, so that's me personally, so it's even more pertinent, I think, maybe as a parent. And I know cultures are different, so I know expectations are different with that, so I do understand that, but just the attire, not appropriate in my opinion, and I'm talking about girls ranging from about 7 to 10. I've had situations where I've been taken to the bathroom. I haven't seen anything, but the parent's right there holding the computer, and I'm expected to keep on teaching, so I just don't think that's appropriate. I don't want to teach any of that during that situation. And just taking off clothes because they're hot or whatever. And I understand they're young. They don't understand that. But we're in a delicate situation. Bookings are at a premium right now. My only resolution is to call the firemen. And more often than not, by the time, you know, I'm aware of what's taking place and I call the firemen, the situation's already over with. And then I'm left with a fireman there trying to explain to the parents, and I'm probably going to end up losing bookings in the deal because the parents are going to be maybe embarrassed or whatever. And I'm just in a delicate situation. So I just reached out to VIP Kid and I said, it's no fault of yours, and I know you're in a delicate situation also, but can you please just send a gentle reminder on what's appropriate for the students in the classroom? And I know the parents can't control everything, but just one of those gentle reminders would be a help so that we're not in that delicate situation. And again, I know it's going to happen from time to time. I know they're kids, they don't know, but just to try and minimize that as much as possible. So anyways, that's just the situations I've been seeing as a teacher. I'm sure others have been seeing it too. I'm not trying to put a blame game on VIP Kid or the parents for that matter. I just We are expected as teachers to dress appropriately. I just want the same relative normality with kids. I know it's a little bit different, but anyways, that's the video for today. Please like the video. Please subscribe. Come back, and we'll do a video in the next few days. Bye, everybody.